First, there was the planet, and then came people. And for thousands and thousands of years, they coexisted happily. The planet and everything in it worked together, which was good. But it wasn't quite good enough, because life was tough. Everything had to be done by hand, and it was hard work. So people invented technology and machines to help them, and the machines worked, and life became a little easier, which was good. But it wasn't quite good enough, because these machines used fossil fuels like coal and oil, and fossil fuels release lots of carbon into the atmosphere. And lots of carbon in the atmosphere is the main cause of climate change. So people looked for a different kind of energy. A clean energy, like that from the sun, the earth, the wind, and the sea. And the best part was, they didn't release any carbon into the atmosphere. So they called it carbon-free energy, which was good. But it wasn't quite good enough, because there are times and places when the sun doesn't shine or the wind doesn't blow, which means sometimes there just isn't enough carbon-free energy available for everyone, everywhere. But that hasn't stopped people from trying to fix the carbon problem. They do the best they can with the tools they have. But what if they could use carbon-free energy all the time? Every hour of the day, every hour of the night, everywhere, with zero carbon released into the atmosphere. Some of the technology to do this at scale doesn't even exist yet. It would mean working with lots of different people, sharing lots of different ideas, inventing smart new ways to move, store, and generate carbon-free energy. The kind of inventing that gets people at Google very excited. So that's our plan, to be the first major company in the world to run on carbon-free energy by 2030. Which is good, but it isn't quite good enough, because it takes much more than just one company to create a carbon-free future. That's why we're using our technology to help other companies and governments and institutions everywhere become carbon-free. And we're giving billions of people access to tools and information to lead a more carbon-free life. So that for thousands of years to come, people and planet can coexist happily. The planet and everything in it working together. Again.